Hello, welcome back to part 8 of this video tutorial, how to build a Pac-Man game in XNA. Please don't forget to buy the content. Send €2.95 to PayPal accounts XNA Pac-Man 2013 at hotmail.com. We send the content in 24 hours to your email address. In this tutorial, we're gonna implement the animation in the Pac-Man class. But before we can do that, we need to build the draw method in the animation class. So let's do that first. Public forge draw, we need the sprite pads, we need the vector 2 for the origin, and we need a boolean which indicates if Pac-Man is walking or not. Okay, so if is active, only draw the animation if we are active. Okay, and now we're gonna draw the sprite beds. Draw, and we need to draw from the sprite strip to the destination rect, from the source rect, and we have a color, and of course we're gonna use the mat helper to radiance for the rotation. We need to set the origin. We have the sprite effects unknown, and the depth is 0, right? But now the animation is animated all the time. And what if Pac-Man is not walking? If not walking, then source rect is new rectangle 00 frame width and frame height. And what we're gonna do here is that if we're not walking, we put the source rect always to the first picture. If not walking, set the source rect to the first picture of the animation, right? Draw the animation. The actual sprite beds. The origin of the texture indicates if Pac-Man is walking. Okay, draw the draw method for the animation class. And the first thing now we need to do is change the picture of the Pac-Man so that we can use the animation instead of only one Pac-Man. So if you have by the content, go to your content and go to the sprites directory, and we need the Pac-Man animation. So we copy this one and we place it in the content project in the sprites directory. So we're gonna paste it just there. And now we need to change the name here from Pac-Man 1 to Pac-Man Animation. Alright, and with that done, we can go to the Pac-Man class, and the first thing we need to do is define the animation. So we go to the private variable and we define a private animation, and we call it Pac-Man animation. Right, and there is one thing we need to do more, and that's the boolean walking, which indicates if Pac-Man is walking, right? And this boolean we're gonna set in the update method. So go to the update method, and just after the if is not alive, set the walking flag. And we set walking here default on false. Right? And when we press the key up button, set the walking flag, and this is reset. Set the walking flag. Walking is true, right? And now we can copy this and do the same for key down. For key left and for key right, and every time we push these buttons, the animation knows that we're walking. All right, and with this done, let me create the animation in the constructor. So go to the constructor and create the animation. So Pac-Man animation is new animation, all right? And with this done, we need to build the load content method. So let's override it from the object class. Public overrides the load content, right? Load the contents for the Pac-Man. The content manager and the base load contents, we leave this one in top, so the object class loads the texture for us. And what we're gonna do here right now is that we can initialize the Pac-Man animation. So after it loads the texture, you can say here Pac-Man animation initialize, and now we can set the texture and the position. Frame width and height are 32 and the frame count is 8 and the frame time is 25. Then we set the color, and the color is white. And then we set the scale. Is looping is true, and starting frame is 0. Right? Initialize the animation. Right, and that's all there is for the load content and the initialize. So load content and now we need to go back to the update method because we need to update the animation. right, just after the key write, we can say update the animation, and what we need to update is Pac-Man animation. The position is position, and also we need to update the rotation. And finally, we can do the update of the Pac-Man animation game time, right? And that's all we need to do to update the animation. Updates animation. And the last thing we need to do is draw the animation. And we don't have a draw yet in the Pac-Man class, so we need to build the draw method so we can override it from the object class. Public override the draw method. One thing we not need here is the base draw. We don't want to draw in the base class. So draw the animation. And the actual sprite bits, and we're gonna draw only if is alive. That's for sure. And now we can draw the animation. And what we do here is Pac-Man animation dot draw, and then we need to give the sprite bats the center, and the center we need to set, and the walking, which indicate if we walk or not, and we need to set the center, and the center we set it in the load content after we have load of initialized the animation. So let's here set the center, and that's done. Center is Pac-Man animation. Alright, it's a new vector too. Pac-Man animation dot frame width divide by 2, and Pac-Man animation frame height divide by 2. So now we have the center for the draw method. And that's all there is to implement the animation in Pac-Man. So let's see if it works for us. And there it is. I'm gonna end the tutorial here. In the next tutorial, we're gonna implement the animation in the Coast class. So I hope you enjoy, and see you in the next tutorial. Bye.